prophecy, didn't he? He knew they were going to try to be like everybody else.
Yeah.
That's why he told them to kill everybody.
Yeah.
Kill everything.
Right.
I don't even remind of these people to be where you are, because I don't want you to be like them. I want you to be like I want you to be. You will certainly set a sovereign over you, whom Almighty Yahweh Elohim will choose. He said, I'm going to give you one. Because since you want one, set a sovereign over you from among your brothers. He's going to be right there from among you. And you are not allowed to set a foreigner over you who is not your brother. Well, I wonder where Trump come from. He's not my brother.
That's right. He ain't my brother.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, brother, that's not politically correct to say that. Forget politically correct. I'm going to tell you the truth.
That's right.
See, whenever somebody became a king, they needed to know Torah.
That's right.
Not only know it, but make sure that it's being practiced in his kingdom. And if he didn't know Torah, he had a prophet there that will teach him Torah.
He had to know the first five books.
And if he didn't do that, the kingdom will suffer.
Hallelujah.
And people, I'm going to save the country another $10 million. It's going to keep on suffering until this country repents of all of his evils. I just learned the other day that in this family planning program, 18 million babies have been sacrificed. 18 million. And the number climbs every day. I don't know who family they're planning, but I don't want to plan mine. If all they're doing is killing babies. One thing that upsets our father is murdering children. That's why Egypt suffered so bad. He said, you kill my sons.
I'm gonna kill you.
Now your son get ready to die. If you don't have the blood on the doorposts and the lintels, your son, not only your son, but the firstborn of everything that belongs to you.
Right.
You don't think Almighty Yah get upset because people have painted him as this little squishy, calm thing sitting up in heaven blessing everybody.
Yes.
That's not him. People better wake up.
Yes,
Almighty Yah is angry.
Yes, he is.
For what we're doing in his land. With his word. After he done gave his only begotten son.
Yes.
And we trashing that.
Trashing. Yes.
If you think he's not upset, keep living.
Yeah, that's right.
And you'll see for yourself.
For yourself, that's right.
He's not playing.
Hallelujah.
It's coming down to the finality of all things, my brothers and sisters. And I'm not going to stand here and mess with the Hebraic and mess with the Aramaic and mess with the English and the Latin and all that. What we need to know is, are we right with the Father in our heart? You can learn all that other stuff if you want to. Because I heard him say, if you have all knowledge, and have not love,
it profits nothing.
It profits you nothing. Matter of fact, I studied sheep a little bit the other day because you keep hearing references that we are the sheep, not the goat. Well, a sheep is a very intelligent animal. But it's also humble.
Yes.
I don't care if you get a whole lot of intellect,
right,
but you should not ever lose your humility.
Humility.
Sheep will follow his master wherever he brings
him.
Go wherever he sends him. And do whatever he's told to do. Without button. Like old goat.
Hallelujah.
I hope we got a flock of sheep in here.
Hallelujah.
Because I'm a sheep myself.
Yes.
Right.
Hallelujah.
All of us are under the master shepherd.
Yes. Hallelujah. Praise you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Going back to 1 Samuel chapter 8. Go there with me. Verse number 6, he said, but the word was evil. Y'all see that?
Yes.
It was evil in the sight and the eyes of Samuel when they said, give us a king to rule us. You know, that man was hurt. So he went praying to the Father. Father, they don't love me. He took it personal.
Yes.
I know y'all won't do that, right? Don't lie, man.
Hallelujah.
Because I take it personal. I'm gonna be honest, you know what I mean? Yeah. When you talk about COY, you talking about me.
Right.
When you go against Almighty Yah, you going against me.
Yes, right.
When you say there ain't no Yahshua, you hurt me to my heart.
To my heart.
Because I love it.
Yes.
When you say the scriptures is not real, you messing with my life.
Right. There's my food and my drink.
Verse number 7 says, and Almighty Yah said to Shemuel, listen to the voice of the people and all that they say to you. For they have not rejected you, Shemuel, but they have rejected me from reigning over them. Don't take it personal, Shemuel. They're not mad with you. They want you, but they don't want me.
That's right.
So the Father said, whatever they sing, brothers and sisters, I'm going to tell you what, sometimes we ask for stuff that we don't want. I preach the message was you got what you want. But do you want what you got? A lot of people want a husband. Oh, but they don't know how to be a wife. A lot of the men want wives. Don't know how to be a husband. They fall in love with the ideology of marriage, but they don't understand marriage. Mr. Johnson said, until they become.
Yes, a love affair.
Which means it's a work in progress until you die.
With love.
Until death.
Thank you, God.
Do you part.
Hallelujah.
Until the end, you follow the dictates of Scripture. Because Scripture is always right.
Always.
It seems as though we always wrong.
That's right.
Trying to do things like everybody else. How many of y'all know your marriage don't work like mine?
No.
Well, everybody else husband doing this, well, go with everybody else. Everybody else's wife is doing that, well, go with everybody else's wife. This is yours. And if she's not doing or if he's not doing what everybody else is doing, you ought to get on your face and thank the Father. That you got a wife or a husband that don't mind being an individual.
That's right.
Especially if that's one that's willing to learn. Verse number 8 says, according to all the works which they have done since the day that I brought them out of Mithraim, Egypt, even to this day, they're forsaking me and serving other mighty ones, so they are doing to you.
That's right. Hallelujah.
How, that's why I tell people, because people be around me and they say, ooh, don't cuss Brother Isaac here. I say, hold it. If you want to cuss, cuss. Don't stop cussing because of me. If you can cuss in his face, why are you worried about mine? I can't save you. And I'm not gonna let you give me more honor than you give to him. But if you want to cuss, you go right ahead on. I saw a preacher one time, I didn't call no name, but I used to collect insurance. I went to his house to collect insurance, and on my way up the drive-walk, I saw him sticking something behind the chair, and I looked close, and it was a Budweiser. So I'm writing him up, you know, collecting my money and everything. I said, preacher. He said, what's up? I said, do me a favor. He said, what's that? I said, get your beer from behind that chair before it get hot. He said, oh, you saw that? I said, yes, sir, I did. I don't want you hiding it from me, and you doing it in front of him. Who am I? But a servant of the Most High. You see, when we learn our place, it's easy to stay in our place instead of trying to be like everybody else. Mr. Johnson used my brother BJ this morning and talked about his 50 some odd years with that Elois. Yeah. 50 some odd years together.
That's a blessing.
Hallelujah.
When you hear the song that says, I've been through the storm and the rain.
Yes.
That's them.
Yes.
But I made it.
Yeah.
That's them.
That's them.
If you need to talk to somebody who has successfully kept a marriage together for 50 some odd years, you need to call them up and go talk to them. There's a lot of wisdom in there. A lot of mountains been climbed.
Yeah.
A lot of valleys been entertained.
Yes. Yeah.
Crossed many rivers.
That's right.
And they're still holding on.
That's a blessing. Well, yeah, you can learn some.
See, when the Father gives us something to look at, I don't have to look at John Doe down the road, the drunk with a wife 60 years. What am I looking at him for?
Yeah.
He get drunk and beat his poor wife.
I think that's a...
He go off sometimes, stay on a drunk binge for 7 days and don't come home. What am I looking at him for? I want to look at somebody who's staying with y'all. Because just because you got a marriage and everything going well don't mean you're going into the kingdom. We need to know that. You and your sweet little marriage going to hell if you don't repent of your sins. Praise y'all, somebody. I tell somebody the spirit said, now, brother, you didn't have to go there. Yes, I did. Because I'm going to do what he told me to do. And I'm going to speak what he told me to speak.
That's right.
Somebody need to hear that.
That's right.
Hosea 4:6 said, my people perish. There it is right there. That's our motto.
That's right. That's right.
Because we can come in here and think we know and don't know. And I learned a message at Tabernacle before Jim Brother Grant made the statement. And I made that statement famous. And I preached the message. Labeled that after that statement. You don't know what you don't know. And that's the truth. Because the minute you think you know something, the Father come up and show you you didn't know nothing. Just like this verse of scripture right here, Hosea 4:6. I read it many times as I was reading through the whole passages of the scriptures. But when I read it, when the Father told me to preach it, everything started bursting out of it. And I started seeing things I had not seen before. And I said, I was just as ignorant as I could be, thinking I was smart. And I'm still ignorant. Matter of fact, me and Brother Roland, we pleaded guilty ignorant. I ain't know. My people are destroyed. Now that's the Father we serve. He will destroy you. Y'all heard that, right?
Yes.
Brother Ali didn't say that, right? That's in your book?
Yes.
My people are destroyed for what?
Lack of knowledge.
And because you reject knowledge, what is he going to do?
Reject you.
He's going to reject you for being a priest unto him.
Right.
Now that's the part that the Father told me, I want you to save that one. The last end of that. First, he wants us to understand he's going to reject us from being priests unto him.
Yeah.
Y'all hear that?
Yeah.
That means that we are void of Torah. Because a priest got to